all living things die. This can be due to old age, disease, by accident, or by natural or man-made disaster. To ensure their continuation of species so they do not go extinct, living things reproduce. As we learned in our very first video, What is Biology? Reproduction is a characteristic unique to living things. Non-living things obviously cannot reproduce. In today's video, we will discuss what asexual reproduction is and what are some of its types. There are two major types of reproduction: sexual and asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is reproduction that involves the fusion of two reproductive cells or gametes. Gametes are sex cells, specifically produced by organisms for sexual reproduction. Gametes can be male or female, depending on the type of cells they produce. These are not needed in case of asexual reproduction, as there are no male and female structures involved in this process. Asexual reproduction is the production of new individuals that does not involve fertilization, that is, there is no fusion of two reproductive cells. In asexual reproduction, organisms reproduce by mechanisms like budding, spore formation, or vegetative propagation. In such mechanisms, organisms produce identical copies of themselves by reproduction. Vegetative reproduction or propagation is a form of asexual reproduction found in plants. It usually involves the growth of a new part of a plant, usually a bud or a stem, which eventually becomes separated from the parent plant to form a new individual. In this way, several plants can be produced from a single parent plant. Did you know that a very common root plant that we use in our food every day is also a way of a plant to reproduce asexually? Yes, ginger is one of those, and so are onions. Many flowering plants reproduce vegetatively by means of underground storage organs such as ginger and onions. Gingers come under a broader category of rhizomes, and onions under bulbs. Tubers, like potatoes, are also a way of plants to reproduce asexually. These underground storage organs are also called perennating organs because they help plants survive year to year, a process called perennation. The food stored in the underground storage organ enables the plant to survive through unfavorable climatic conditions. When the return of favorable conditions, the buds utilize up the stored food and develop rapidly into new plants.